So, Kentucky Hemp Lecture Series carries on. Alright, we're talking about the seven different university projects, okay? So we got all these different projects. The only way that any state can raise hemp is if the agricultural department and the university collaborates and they figure out some sort of research to do it on, okay? So, the Hemp Lecture Series. Seven university projects. Here we go. So, the first project was the Old Kentucky Heirloom Seed, which was being done through the Kentucky State University and some Eastern Kentucky plot. The second one is a Western Kentucky effort, right? So, they're going to be raising seeds in Western, Eastern. I heard hemp could grow all over the, you know, all over the United States. It doesn't actually need, like, a specific fertile ground. Also heard that it replenishes it, but there's a lot of propaganda out there. There's a lot of people that hate, you know, marijuana, so they're going to say, oh, it's useless, and then there's people that love it. They're like, oh, it's going to be a godsend. So I think it's between those two, right? A Western Kentucky effort in conjunction with Murray State University is going to examine how well European seeds for hemp grows in Kentucky. So the second one is through Murray State University, and they're going to check out the European seeds. Now, that's probably tied into the Italian seeds that had got confiscated by the DEA at the Louisville Airport, right? That's incredible, right? When the government actually gets the seeds, then the DEA intervenes. But how many times has marijuana gone through UPS at Louisville? They haven't done anything about it. UPS knows that they're delivering marijuana. They don't care. They just want to deliver their packages, right? Make their customers happy. FedEx, UPS, y'all probably been drug dealers for lots of people for many years. Okay, so that's the second one is Murray State cultivation of European seed for the purposes of studying the hemp fiber. So is the Italian seed good? I heard the Russian seed is the best, okay? The Russian seed. The Chinese seed, the Italian seed, and actually, if you look at the history of the hemp industry in Kentucky, there was a big debacle about getting all the seeds here. So when they first started raising hemp in Kentucky in the 1800s, we've already seen this issue happen. There wasn't enough seeds. They had a big problem with it. When you raise hemp, you got to spread seeds out all over the place. I think like 500 pounds of seed is only enough for 10 acres, something like that. And so that's another thing. If we need to fully legalize marijuana so that way everybody can be doing their experiments. Everybody can just raise it in their yard and try to figure out the medicinal purposes. Because if we're only checking out hemp, we're only checking out the stalk, but we're not actually checking out the bloom, right? The flower. And there's potential with the flower. You got THC, CBD. There's 75 different active compounds in it. It truly is a gift from God. We got these cannabinoid receptors. And so when we take that in, when we intake it through, you know, hemp oil, Jamaican hemp oil, Ronnie Lee Smith hemp oil, whenever we intake it that way, it turns these receptors on. So actually, it's our body needs this stuff, and the marijuana connects it. So you have a receptor, it turns it on, makes your organs stronger, makes your body act better, shrinks tumors, et cetera, et cetera. Third project, Central Kentucky. This is through the University of Kentucky and Eastern Kentucky. So, again, you know, there's some colleges that aren't being, they're totally being looked over, right? They're not even, but UK and Eastern Kentucky, both Lexington and Richmond, they're focused on basic agriculture issues involved in industrial hemp production. Now, hemp is going to be a good replacement crop for tobacco. But what do you actually need to raise hemp, right? You need to spread the seed everywhere, so you need some sort of seed spreader. And then when it starts raising, actually, you don't even need herbicides or pesticides. It's just going to raise up. But when it gets to be so tall, you're going to need to figure a way to chop it. You know, chop all of it, put it in a pile, it dries, and then you're going to have to try to take the fibers, right? You're going to have to try to, like, take each piece of the fiber off. And what do we need? How much is that going to cost for productions? What type of machinery will we need? You'll probably still need, you know, tractors, and you might need some pesticides, some herbicides, but not very much because you're spreading them all over the place, so you're not going to have any weeds. And generally, there's not many pesticides that you need, you know, because, I don't know, it's not cotton, right? It's not cotton. Now, I've heard sometimes people say it's actually softer, but see, I don't know if I believe that than cotton. It seems like it's a more durable product. It's more coarser, but that's good for, like, products like shoes, jeans, and, jackets or whatever, something that requires something more coarse. If you want something soft, I've heard actually, like, they combine hemp with silk to be able to make some lingerie. So soft, but yet durable. But I don't know. Just the idea of him just makes it sound like it's already going to be scratchy. So that's Central Kentucky. That's the third project. They're going to be testing industrial hemp just to kind of check out the production cost of the machinery for the planting, harvesting, and transportation. We're testing the European seeds. That was the second one. And then the first one, we was doing the Kentucky seeds. So we're testing the Kentucky seed. European seeds are just general. How do you raise it? What type of machinery do we need? And really, in order to understand what type of machinery do you need, you have to figure out what products are going to be best utilized by hemp. The fifth project is Eastern Kentucky. Again, Eastern Kentucky gets another one, and it's also linked for UK. So Eastern Kentucky and UK get another one. The Kentucky State's got one. Murray State's got one. EKU and UK's got two. And they're going to study hemp's potential as an alternative energy source. Genius idea. We need to get off of the fossil fuels. Everybody should have solar panels everywhere. We should also have a lot of nuclear plants. Kentucky needs to get off, we're a coal state. Actually, we should nationalize coal, take that coal, it's ours, okay? Make electricity for free for everybody in Kentucky. With the money that we make by taking our coal back, taking it out of the greedy corporation's hands, out of Mitch McConnell's hands, take our coal, reinvest that money that we get by having coal, being ours, reinvest that in nuclear power, reinvested in hemp oil, reinvested in solar power. We have an energy crisis. We should have solar panels everywhere. Solar is continuous and nonstop. Why would you not have solar power on your roof? The sun just grinds in all day, right? Just shine, shine, shine right on top of your house. You can be collecting all that energy. You can be fueling your entire house. Instead, we're being forced to use coal, so we're being forced to burn the little bit of limited fossil fuels that we have, and we're being forced to pay high electricity bills because we're not even trying to check out other things. Even George W. Bush says we should check out switchblade grass. Anyways, hemp has the potential as being an alternative energy source, renewable energy research, so they're going to be doing this with a crop at its EKU Craft Center. So it's Eastern Kentucky and UK. It's linked with UK's for the measuring agriculture production, and that's the fifth project. The sixth project is located in the urban brownfield, and it's affiliated with U of L. So finally, U of L actually got one of them. They will study bioremediation and the detoxifying and the environmental effects of industrial hemp. So industrial hemp, it stops soil erosion. I heard it actually replenishes the soil. You can raise it for 20 years, and it doesn't take any nutrients away from it. Again, we actually got to test it out because there's some people that say hemp is going to cure everybody's ills. You start raising hemp and then everybody's going to be millionaires. That would be true for marijuana, but we have to raise it as hemp. So we have to raise all these seeds real close together, and we can only do it for research purposes as of this point. But we need to legalize it. We need to have a full-blown legalize. It needs to happen through Frankfurt and the senators that are running for our vote need to talk about these things because these things are important. It's also better for medicine that we actually get the blooms and the THC. CBDs are good, but some people say the CBDs actually turn the THC off. And there's a synergy thing. We need THC, CBD. When their powers combine, they become Captain Planet, and they can save everybody's lives, right? Epilepsy, glaucoma, cancer, on and on, just saving everybody's life, unless an Arizona jail arrests you or your sister forces you to get chemotherapy, then you die. But if you know the benefits of hash oil, Jamaican hash oil, then you would have a stronger body, stronger mind. Your cannabinoid receptors would be activated, and therefore your body would actually be getting the other element that has been missing all of its life. So, bioremediation, detoxifying environmental effects of industrial hemp, hemp history, replenish the soil. Chris Pointer, a spokesman for the mayor, said hemp can pull many contaminants out of the soil of former industrial sites. A valuable step towards potentially redeveloping brownfields. So, the industries that we have out here, the coal plants, they totally ruin the soil that they're on, but with hemp, maybe we can actually rejuvenate that. I don't feel like this is that important because, yeah, it's important, but there's lots of soil out here that doesn't need any sort of remediation. We should be, I don't know. It's got its use. It's got its use, but there's not like huge swaths of fields that are being, you know, inactivated because it's got lots of radiation. This would be good for like Arizona because they got, you know, lots of nuclear testing going on out there, but it's in the desert. In Kentucky, I'm not sure how many brown fields there are in Kentucky. But that's what U of L is doing. At least they jumped on the bandwagon. They got themselves something. So there's six projects that's happening right now in Kentucky, and those are the six projects. They got specific qualities, and that's what we're doing. Okay, so hemp, cannabis, and mushrooms can be used to clean up and protect us from radioactive pollution and nuclear disasters. There's seven hemp projects. Six of them are relying on the European industrial hemp seed, which we know is being held hostage by the DEA and U.S. Customs and Louisville right now. The seventh project being conducted with Kentucky State University is using the heirloom Kentucky hemp seed, which I believe to be, or this person that's writing this believes it to be superior. I don't know why, but maybe the heirloom Kentucky hemp seed is some quality, like just magical seed. You plant the Kentucky heirloom seed, and then you'll get a big old beanstalk that'll take you to a goose that lays golden eggs and, you know, a big giant in the sky, some invisible man in the sky. So that's the seventh project, right? Kentucky State University. It was actually the first one that I mentioned, but whatever. It's planted near Mount Vernon. It's grown by a group called Growing Warriors. This person says, let's raise it everywhere, the heirloom Kentucky seed. Holly Von Lurthy, James Comer, Chief of Staff, said farmers can sign up through the Agricultural Department's website. And the link will be located down below. It's a PDF document. You'll have to fill out the application. It's only like a page long. Say the reasons why you want to raise it. Put it out there. I don't see why you would be rejected. I don't see why anybody would be rejected. It's politics, so maybe they'll do background check on you to see if you're a pothead or if you've been, you know, busted for any type of bad criminal things. They probably won't. They probably, if you're a farmer and you're in land and you want to do some things, I would think that they probably would just let you do it. I don't know what the process actually is, but it starts with an application. So if you're interested in doing it, fill out the application, send it to the Department of Agriculture and see what happens. Kentucky, and do that, because that's actually a really good idea. You'll be doing it in the very beginning. You'll get involved in the system. Eventually, I think that hemp will go the same route that tobacco did. There's only 70 pounds that Kentucky would raise, and they would sell base. So every piece of land had so much base of tobacco that you were allowed to raise. That kept people from raising unlimited amounts. So, you know, some people could only raise 5 acres or whatever, 5,000 pounds. And that's all. That was the maximum that you could do. And if you wanted to raise any more, you'd have to buy someone else's base, or you'd have to buy someone else's land. And they'll probably do the same thing with hemp. So everybody would be allowed to raise, you know, a certain amount of hemp, but that's it. And you could sell that right to anybody else. And if you sell the rights, then you can't actually raise it yourself. So yeah, that's the university projects that's going along with hemp. Now last. Or this year, you had Julie Denton, a Republican, right? We've settled. That is the Republicans, the Kentucky Republicans, that's actually pushing these progressive measures, which sickens me to my stomach. A Democrat means you're for prohibition. Have y'all read your history books? Read your damn history books. Prohibition failed. It failed. It was a nice experiment, but Kentuckians, Americans, you tell them not to do something that they want to do. You try to make gay sex illegal, right? Sodomy. Did you stop it? You think there's no gay people around? 1 out of 10 people are gay. 1 out of 10. Okay? So you're not stopping diddly shit. So, okay. So Kentucky legalized medical marijuana with the Senate Bill 124. And they did it this year. February 7th. 1 year. Or no, actually that was the amendment to the hemp thing. But that, it doesn't matter. It was this year, right? So the year later they did this. And Julie Denton, okay? So Julie Denton is the Republican that had pushed for it. Now, what you need to know about it is that it's the CBD medical marijuana bill. So they had legalized cannabidiol, okay? So THC, they're not doing anything with the THC. THC is the active ingredient that gets you high. Now, a lot of times people thought that the THC was also the cancer curing agent. So they would try to isolate the THC away from the rest of the plant, and that would be what they thought that was curing cancer. But now some of the studies are kind of showing that the CBD actually has the qualities that are, you know, used medically, that have the good medical qualities that people want. So this is only CBDs. Also, there's some people that say they combine, they're synergy, and then there's some people that say that they're opposed to each other. So I think they should both be legal, so that way we can get whatever. But CBDs have been known to help people with epilepsy, and it is a step in the right direction, and it was done by a Republican. So thank God for Julie Denton and the Republicans for getting hemp and medical marijuana legalized in Kentucky.